So, Sri Guru Bhyo Namaha, we are going to start the Rudram and the Chamakam class today. And the style, teaching style will be the traditional Gurukul style. And you don't need a book at this point. The Vedas are called Shruti. Shruti means being heard. You can use the book as a reference later on when you have to practice. You need the book because you need that to get the words. So for that you can get it, because it is also recorded. You all can later on go back to the recording. Normally these classes would go on a daily basis, but because of the distance and the time it takes to come to a place, we'll be having classes weekly basis. But the week's class, once you practice the week's class the next 6 days, then the next day it will be easier. So that is then only we can finish in like 6 months. Otherwise it can go for a very long time. So it also needs a lot of commitment from the students, and the most important thing about chanting is the Taittiriya Upanishad. It actually says how Veda should be chanted. Siksham vyakhya syamaha varna swaraha matra balam sama santanaha. So there are 6 things which are required in chanting. Varnaha means the letter. So the letter, how the letter is chanted, you don't need to know any language. That's what I'm saying. The language is not important here. You don't have to say, I don't know Hindi, I don't know Sanskrit, I don't know Tamil, I don't know English. No, the language is not important. It is just a sound. Just like any music, when you get a mridangam sound, it is a sound. Your ears are getting the sound. Same way, we just have to listen to the sound carefully and then repeat. Because that words, each word has to be chanted exactly the way it should be chanted. So that is varnaha, means the letter. Then the swaraha. Again, this is unique to the Vedas. The difference between a shlokam and the Veda mantram is that Vedas have what is called a swaram. Many of you would have known what a swaram is. In music also, we have swaram, where we have sapta swarama, 7 notes. Sa, ri, ga. So we have 7 swaras. In Vedas, it is slightly easier. We have only 3 swarams. One is a lower one, one is a middle one, one is the upper one. So there are only 3 swarams. So it will be much easier. It is easier than learning music, because in music you have to get to know the exactly 7. Here it is only 3. So that is swaraha. Parna swaraha. Then matra. Matra is the amount of time you spend for each letter. Then, so if it is something is called a dirgham, which is a long vowel, say, You say Rama, that ma is a short vowel. You say Rama. If say you have to say Rama, ma, that is the ending ma is a, or a Rama. So both Ra and Ma, they are long vowels. So it is called Dirgham. So you have Hrasvam, which is a short vowel, and the Dirgham is long vowel Rama. So you have to give that particular matra. Matra are the time. Matram is the time for that particular. You cannot say in between. It has to be very precise. You have to be Rama or Rama. You cannot be Rama, which is in between these two. So there is no in between. Even in swaram, you will come to know that if it is upper swaram, it has to be upper, middle or lower. If somebody, learn properly and then you try to chant with others, then you will notice all those subtle differences. that others are chanting, they are also chanting swaram, but it is neither up nor in the middle, it is in between. So you say you have 0, 1 and minus 1, that is how it has to be chanted. Not mostly the chanting as we see is they chant 0.5 up and 0.5, or it is not even clear what they are trying to chant. So varnaha, so swaraha is what is this one. Varna, swaraha, matra. Then balam is the stress, how much of the stress you give to each letter. Again, this is that balam is that strength for letter. Balam, sama, santanaha. Sama is the speed. The speed you are going to chant. It is not like a very high speed or too low speed. Then Shruti, all of us, we are going to chant the Shruti. We have to chant in exactly the same, all of us have to chant in the same Shruti. So these are all the rules for chanting. So once we know all this, it is going to be easier. And don't really go into all the details which I have just said, because once you repeat, it is going to be very easy. Once you just repeat that, you just get the sound right, and then I will be listening to how you are repeating, and it will be easier. So the way you will be doing it, I will say once, and then you will repeat twice. Same thing. Om Namo Bhagavate.
Om Namo Bhagavate. Om Namo Bhagavate.
Rudraya.
Rudraya. Rudraya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya. Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya.
So when you say that after the day, that Ru should not come down. Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya. Dhraya, only Dhra should come down.
Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya. Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya.
Om Namaste Rudra.
Om Namaste Rudra. Om Namaste Rudra.
So again, it's all the same. So when the reason I'm saying these are all subtleties. Mostly when I hear Namaste Rudra, that Ru will come, should not come down here. Namaste, Namaste Rudra,
Namaste Rudra, Namaste Rudra.
Manyava,
Manyava, Manyava.
Udota Ishave Namaha.
Udota Ishave Namaha. Udota Ishave Namaha.
Namaha.
Namaha. Namaha.
Om Namaste Rudra Manyava. Utota Ishave Namaha.
Om Namaste Rudramanyava Utota Ishave Namaha. Om Namaste Rudramanyava Utota Ishave Namaha.
Namaste Rudra Manyava Manyava Manyava. Namaste
Rudra Manyava. Namaste Rudra Manyava. Namaste Rudra Manyava.
Utota Ishave Namaha.
Utota Ishave Namaha.
Om. We just started the Rudram. Those just came in. Just explained the basically how the Rudram is going to be chanted. The classes will be once in a week, and you need to practice. It is recorded in the it is there in the YouTube, so you can start practicing the particularly the first initial. I just explained how this should be chanted. So I'm not going to repeat now because it is already recorded. You can go back and then you can make sure that you get to that first initially what I get understand that we just started. So we'll the way I will say once and you will have to repeat two times. Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya. Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya.
Om Namaste Rudra.
Om Namaste Rudra. Om Namaste Rudra.
So when there is no swaram for something, when it has to be in the same Namaste Rudra, that Ru is very important because the natural tendency will be to bring that Ru down. Namaste, because this is, and also when you would have heard many times Rudram, mostly the problem with when these subtleties are not known and people chant, and 90% chant like that. They all chant in the wrong way. And the problem is they don't know that they are chanting in the wrong way. So if you don't know what you don't know, that is the biggest problem. Because you don't know, you are assuming that, because that small subtlety is not only when you learn, if you learn from a cassette, nobody, the cassette, you are just listening. Nobody is going to say, this is how it, this is a small thing you need to know. This is the, because there are a lot of technical issues, technical things where we need to be very careful. Om Namaste Rudra Manyava.
Om Namaste Rudra Manyava. Om Namaste Rudra Manyava.
Namaste Rudra Manyava.
Namaste Rudra Manyava. Namaste Rudra Manyava.
Utota Ishave Namaha.
Utota Ishave Namaha. Utota Ishave Namaha.
Namaste Astu.
Namaste Astu. Namaste Astu.
Dhanvane.
Dhanvane. Dhanvane.
Namaste Astu Dhanvane.
Namaste Astu Dhanvane. Namaste Astu Dhanvane.
Bahubhyam Utate.
Bahubhyam Udate, Bahubhyam Udate,
Namaha,
Namaha, Namaha.
So, just want to make sure you all, the first one line. So, what I would suggest, like three of you, you try to say so that I know how, that this is, I've chanted very, you have chanted at least 10 times. Just to make sure everybody gets it, I just want you say three students at this at one time so that I can clearly hear. Oh, first you see.
Om Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha. Om Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha.
Perfect. Next.
Om Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha. 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 Om Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha.
When the first, when you are going to the first, you don't need the book actually at this point, because I'm breaking it into small. The when we see a book later on, when we practice, you need to see the book. But right now, when you see the book, the brain 50 to 60% is going into our eyes. So what is important at this point is, we have to get into our brain and memorize it. So when you do it with your book, your brain is knows that the book, the eyes are seeing something. So they don't want to actually memorize it, because they know that the eyes are there. So that brain knows how to minimize its work. It is all, our human body is like a great machine. It knows how to minimize. So it will immediately stop that activity, because it's, you are anyway seeing the next letter. We are saying na, then namaste, okay, ma is there. So it is going to stop at that time. So I'm going to teach in a very small one letters, so that when you repeat many times, you will easily get it. You might think, oh, this is very difficult, but it is not difficult. It is just that when we practice, when you put our mind, and most important is, this is what my guru always says, whenever you do anything, do it with 100% effort and concentration, or do not do it. It is like crossing a well. If you want to cross a well, you have to just have a small, like you have a small water body, which is just 1 foot. If you have to cross it, you have to jump, right? You have to just put a longer step to go from one side to the other side. If you say that I will do 99% crossing, then you will still end up in the water, because you will not cross the other side. You have to do 100%. So it is like, if you want to practice in, you want to participate in the Olympics, you just have to say that because it is Olympics, I cannot win. There will be others who are like Carl Lewis or I cannot win 100 meters with them. I cannot compete. If you think you have that attitude, it is better not to go. You have to say that you cannot say, the wording is, you cannot, it's like I too ran is not what is required here. You have to always think you are going to win. You are going to think always that your chanting is going to be the best chanting. That is the attitude, first of all. If that, because if you have that attitude, then you will put more efforts to make sure that you come to that level. Yet it has to be 100%, not 99%. That is, I'm just putting this so that you get this aspect of how we want to chant, and we will get it. So you may, if you want to get only 80% chanting efficiency, you will make a lot of mistakes. Then within 2 days, you can learn Rudram. Because you may think, oh, for 80%, just 2 days are required. But for 100% accuracy, I need to work 6 months. So you will think, okay, 80%. So many, when I talk with many, this is what they say. When I was 7 years old, when I start, my grandfather was teaching me Rudram. Because I was very young, my one other student was a 65-year-old man at that time. So because I was young, within one day I can chant exactly, because I remember it is just the age. Then my grandfather will spend a lot of time on him. Sometimes I will get bored. He said, no, you have to be the same. But this is also I learned. We have to respect, even if we are good or something, we have to have that equal respect for everybody. We cannot always think, I am superior, I am better. That I learned from a very young age that never to have that attitude. It's very, very important not to have that attitude. So then that other person said to my grandfather, near Mailapur, Raja Annamalaipuram, he said, in the Kapalishwarar temple, every Pradosham, they chant Rudram. I do not want to learn in such a perfect way. I just want to just follow them chanting. That is what my intention is. Then my grandfather said, no, if you have that attitude, then you stop the class right now. Because that is, then he said, no, I am old, I may not get. He said, no, age does not matter. Whatever be the age, if you have the right attitude, you can also perfectly chant. And if you are thinking that you just want to be like also ran, it is not good at all. And never have that attitude. Always have the attitude that you are going to win or you are going to be the best. So that is a very critical attitude for learning the Rudram chanting. And if you see all the Vedic pundits, Ati Rudram or Maharudram happening in Sringeri, there will be thousands of Vedic priests chanting, but there will be only one voice heard and one Shruti. Why? Because all the thousand have learned in one way, particular way. So if we all learn in one way, it doesn't matter that they would have learned, they come from different parts of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka. That is where the priests will come. But they all learn from different people. But why is it that all are chanting? Because they all learned perfectly. The problem I find here is they just want to quickly get it, like a fast food. They want just very quick. That's okay, let me get in. I just need 9. Even in companies also, they say you follow the 80-20 rule, because they know that with 20% effort, you can get 80%. But here, the 80-20 rule, those rules are not going to apply. It is 120-20 rule, or 100, it is 100% rule. You have to get a 20-20 vision. So that is very important. Om Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha.
Om Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha. Om Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha.
What of you? Just come friend. All of you can come. Friend, it is much easier. Yeah.
Namaste astu dhanvane bhagubhya mutate namaha. Namaste astu dhanvane bhagubhya mutate namaha.
Namaste asu dhanvane bhagubhya mudate namaha.
Namaste asu dhanvane.
Namaste asu dhanvane. Namaste asu dhanvane.
It's better you chant four times. It will be easier. So that when I say the full word, it will be easier for you.
Namaste astu dhanvane. Namaste astu dhanvane.
Bhagubhya mutate namaha.
Bhagubhya mutate namaha. Bhagubhya mutate namaha. Bhagubhya mutate namaha. Bhagubhya mutate namaha.
Also, you have to look at me fully. You cannot be looking here and there. So you have to have that. That is also another thing. Particularly, it is for the kids. You have to have that focus. Just make sure you are looking at me and seeing how, like, from you have to see how the sound comes from the mouth.
And so that, also the lip movement.
Yeah, you have to make sure. Then only you can perfectly get it.
Namaste astu dhanvane bhagubhya mutate namaha.
Namaste astu dhanvane bhagubhya mutate namaha. Namaste astu dhanvane bhagubhya mutate namaha. Namaste astu dhanvane bhagubhya mutate namaha. Namaste astu dhanvane bhagubhya mutate namaha.
Yata ishush.
Yata ishush. Yata ishush. Yata ishush. Yata ishush.
Shivatama.
Shivatama. Shivatama. Shivatama. Shivatama.
Shivam. Shivam bhuvate.
Shivam bhuvate. Shivam bhuvate.
Shivam bhuvate.
Shivam bhuvate. Shivam bhuvate.
Bhuvate.
Bhuvate. Bhuvate.
Shivam. Shivam bhuvate.
Shivam bhuvate. Shivam bhuvate. Shivam bhuvate.
Dhanuhu.
Dhanuhu. Dhanuhu. Dhanuhu.
Yata ishush shivatama.
Yata ishush shivatama. Yata ishush shivatama. Yata ishush shivatama.
Shivam bhuvate dhanuhu.
Shivam bhuvate dhanuhu. Shivam bhuvate dhanuhu.
Yata ishush shivatama. Shivam bhuvate dhanuhu.
Yata ishush shivatama. Shivam bhuvate dhanuhu. Yata ishush shivatama. Shivam bhuvate dhanuhu. Yata ishush shivatama. Shivam bhuvate dhanuhu. Yata ishush shivatama. Shivam bhuvate dhanuhu.
Yata ishush.
Here.
Yata isho shivatama shivam babhuvate dhanuhu.
Yata isho shivatama shivam babhuvate dhanuhu. Yata isho shivatama shivam babhuvate dhanuhu.
So you don't need the book now. You can repeat exactly what I say, so that you get the exact swaram. You don't have to. Later on, when you practice, at that time you can use the book if you want to get that word. Otherwise, you just have to repeat.
Shiva Sharavya.
Shiva Sharavya. Shiva Sharavya. Shiva Sharavya. Shiva Sharavya.
Shiva again.
Shiva Sharavya.
Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
There is no swaram here. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. So it had to be Rudra. I'm hearing that Rook shouldn't come down.
Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Shiva Sharavyaya.
Shiva Sharavyaya. Shiva Sharavyaya. Shiva Sharavyaya. Shiva Sharavyaya.
Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Shiva Sharavyaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Shiva Sharavyaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Shiva Sharavyaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Shiva Sharavyaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Shiva Sharavyaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
So everybody is able to get it, or do you want, if you are, it is up to you. If somebody has still, they want me to repeat once more, please just let me know. So otherwise I will assume that you are all okay. So just, you have to just let me know.
ருதிரமய
Shiva Sharavyaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Shiva Sharavyaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya. Shiva Sharavyaya. Tavataya no Rudra Mridaya.
Yate Rudra.
Yate Rudra. Yate Rudra. Yate Rudra. Yate Rudra.
Shiva Tanu.
Shiva Tanu. Shiva Tanu. Shiva Tanu. Shiva Tanu.
I don't don't hear both of you. You have to give full effort.
Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu.
Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu. Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu. Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu. Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu.
Raghora Papakashini.
Raghora Papakashini. Raghora Papakashini. Raghora Papakashini. Raghora Papakashini.
Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu Raghora Papakashini.
Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu Raghora Papakashini. Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu Raghora Papakashini. Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu Raghora Papakashini. Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu Raghora Papakashini. Yate Rudra Shiva Tanu Raghora Papakashini.
Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas Tanuva. Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas Tanuva. Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas Tanuva. Only the ta should come. Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas Tanuva. Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas Tanuva. Tayanas Tanuva. Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas. So na is all that should be just up. Tayanas Tanuva.
Tayanas Tanuva. Tayanas Tanuva. Tayanas Tanuva.
Shantamaya.
Shantamaya. Shantamaya. Shantamaya. Shantamaya.
Shantamaya. Tayanas Tanuva. Shantamaya.
Tayanas Tanuva. Shantamaya. Tayanas Tanuva. Shantamaya. Tayanas Tanuva. Shantamaya.
Girishanta.
Girishanta. Girishanta. Girishanta. Girishanta.
Bichakashi. Hi.
Bichakashi. Hi. Bichakashi. Hi. Bichakashi. Hi.
Bichakashi. Hi.
Bichakashi. Hi. Bichakashi. Hi.
So in Sanskrit, we have the two dots, the visargam, the two dots, where Ramaha, so that Ha, Ramaha, that Ha sound is coming from the throat. Then you also have a different sound called Ha sound, H-A, Ha. That Ha sound comes from the your bottom navel. It comes from the deep below your stomach. That is where that sound comes. So here this Vichakashi He, this He is not this normal soft He. It is actually the Ha sound, Ha He. So we have to Bichakashi hi.
Bichakashi hi. Bichakashi hi. Bichakashi hi. Bichakashi hi. Vishakashihi.
And also, there is no, so there is a stress given for the dha, but there is no swaram there. It is straight. So it is slightly difficult because when you give a stress, you automatically try to give a swaram. So here there is no swaram, it is flat. He, but only thing is that ha comes from the nabhi. Vichakashihi.
Vichakashihi. Vichakashihi. Vichakashihi.
Vichava vichava.
Bicha cha.
C-H-A.
Vichakashihi.
Vichakashihi. Vichakashihi.
Tayanas tanuva santama yagiri shanta.
Tayanas tanuva santama yagiri shanta.
Yes, up to giri shanta. Tayanas
tanuva santama yagiri shanta. Tayanas tanuva santama yagiri shanta. Trayanas Sanuva Santamaya Girishanta. Trayanas Sanuva Santamaya Girishanta.
Trayanas Sanuva
Santamaya
Girishanta.
Tayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta bhichakashihi.
Tayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta bhichakashihi. Tayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta bhichakashihi. Dayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta vichakashihi. Dayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta vichakashihi.
So, what is your name? Your name?
Aditya.
Aditya. So, make, you have to only focus on me. You cannot see any side. You have to practice. I know it is very difficult for kids. I know, because you have to train your mind. That's what I'm saying. It is not difficult. You, when you train, you just have to focus fully. Then only you can actually, for mainly the kids, the tendency is that after every 3 minutes, our focus will completely go. Because I had the same thing. When I was very young, when I learned, after 1 minute, I cannot focus. So that is normally for every, until you are like 25 or 30, this problem can happen. But you have to just listen and fully see how it is being chanted. So if you are not able to directly see me, you can sit, you can come front, or you have to make sure that you are able to watch me. But when the whole line is chanted at that time, if somebody needs the book, it is still okay at that point. Tayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta bhichakashihi.
Tayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta bhichakashihi. Tayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta bhichakashihi. Tayanas tanuva santamaya girishanta bhichakashihi.
So, what would happen is, the only thing is when you see the book, that there will be small time lag. So that is why I am trying to, mostly the first time when you are doing the whole whole sentence, you may, your mind says that see the book, because it is very long, you cannot remember. So the first two times, yes, it will be difficult, but mostly when we are saying third, fourth time, it will always, that connection will come, so your mind will start remembering it. So initially it is difficult. So is anybody having like a really difficulty when we chant the whole line? Just let me know. Okay. You find it difficult?
Yeah. Can I just suggest?
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Yeah.
Don't underestimate yourself.
Yeah.
It will come.
It will come. So the first.
We were all in the same position. It's not that we are different.
So the first time.
Like he said, fourth time you automatically you remember.
Yeah. So only
so remove the stimuli.
Yeah. Yeah. And also the other thing is, when you, this is first class, so you are trying to get this different. There are so many different things that we are trying to learn at this point. So that is why we find it slightly difficult. So the first anuvaka, if you, Rudram has 11 anuvakas, everything Rudram is 11. So the first anuvaka will take like maybe 50% of the total time. The second will take maybe 40%. So when it comes to the final anuvaka, already everybody would know exactly this is how it should be chanted, that it just comes in. So the learning is not like if you take first anuvaka 3 days, then each anuvaka will be 3 days. No, the learning curve sets in, then you are very, very quick after second anuvaka, then third you are much quicker. So that's how it goes. And so it is only the first class. So do not think that now I am having this difficult, so how I will, so leave all that in mind. Totally have the confidence in you that even if today you are not getting, it will come. My grandfather, I was saying that he recorded that Rudram. The reason why I'm saying, I will share with you how he has chanted the Rudram and how he taught to everybody. So he said that when he was a student, he was a very, very slow learner. When he was like 10 years old, 11 years old, all the other students, they will it will come very fast for them. But my grandfather was a very slow learner. It for others, if it takes 4 times, he has to do 40 times or 50 times. But he never gave up anything. What he was, he always said, he has his chanting. At that time, there was a lot of competition. I'm talking 100 years when there are gadapadigal, there were so many gadapadigals in the villages, and he was like learning in Madurai. At that time, it is not easy because you have a lot of students who are really brilliant students around you. It is very difficult. But he never gave up. He knows that he knew his weakness, that he is a slow learner. So the most important thing in life is know about yourself. If you are slow, it is okay. You can still succeed. The success or failure does not depend on whether you are a slow learner or a fast learner. It does not depend on that at all. Fast learners will fizzle out very fast and they'll just go later on. So if somebody did a research after 50 years, how all those students who were in the school at that time, how they fared later on in their life, you would be surprised that it is totally different. Those who are very brilliant initially may not have had the same success later on. So that is very important. You have to make sure that you will get it with more practice and you will get it. That's the main thing. So do not think that I'm not able to chant at this time. Yes, it is okay. You will get it later on. It is going to come. Yami shungir shantahaste bibharshyastave.
Yami shungir shantahaste bibharshyastave. Yami shungir shantahaste bibharshyastave. Yami shungir shantahaste bibharshyastave. Yami shungir shantahaste bibharshyastave.
Shivangere tratam kuru.
Shivangere tratam kuru. Shivangere tratam kuru. Shivangere tratam kuru.
Shivangere tratam kuru.
Shivangere tratam kuru. Shivangere tratam kuru. Shivam gere ratam kuru.
Mahe gum sif.
Mahe gum sif. Mahe gum sif. Mahe gum sif.
Mahe gum sif.
Mahi gum sif.
Purusham jagat.
Purusham jagat. Purusham jagat. Purusham jagat.
Shivam geret tratam kuru. Mahi gum sif. Purusham jagat.
Shivam geret tratam kuru. Mahi gum sif. Purusham jagat. Shivam geret tratam kuru. Mahi gum sif. Purusham jagat. Shivam geret tratam kuru. Mahi gum sif. Purusham jagat. Shivam geret tratam kuru. Mahi gum sif. Purusham jagat. Shivam geret tratam kuru. Mahi gum sif. Purusham jagat. Shivam geret tratam kuru. Mahi gum sif. Purusham jagat.
So speed also slightly slow. Let it be slow so that everybody can get.
Shivena vachasa vachasa.
Shivena vachasa. Shivena vachasa. Shivena vachasa. Shivena vachasa.
Tva.
Tva.
vachasa tva.
Shivena vachasa tva. Shivena vachasa tva. Shivena vachasa tva. Shivena vachasa tva.
Girishacha vadamasi.
Girishacha vadamasi. Girishacha vadamasi. Girishacha vadamasi. Girishacha vadamasi.
Shivena vachasa tva. Girishacha vadamasi.
Shivena vachasa tva. Girishacha vadamasi. Shivena vachasa tva. Girishacha vadamasi. Shivena vachasa tva. Girishacha vadamasi. Shivena vachasa tva. Girishacha vadamasi. Shivena vachasa tva. Girishacha vadamasi. Shivena vachasa tva. Girishacha vadamasi. Shivena vachasa tva. Girishacha vadamasi.
Yatha na sarva.
Yatha na sarva. Yatha na sarva. Yatha na sarva. Yatha na sarva.
Yatha. Yatha. It's the second ta. Yatha
na sarva. Yatha na sarva. Yatha na sarva. Yatha na sarva.
Mijjagada yakshvagum.
Mijjagada yakshvagum. Mijjagada yakshvagum. Mijjagada yakshvagum. Mijjagada yakshvagum. Mijjagada yakshvagum.
Sumana asate.
Sumana asate. Sumana asate. Sumana asate. Sumana asate.
Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum.
Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum.
Yatha na.
Yatha na sarva
mijjagada yakshmagum.
Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum.
Mijjagada.
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 Yakshmagum.
Yakshmagum. Yakshmagum.
Yatha.
Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum.
Suvarna asate.
Suvarna asate. Suvarna asate.
Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Sumana asate.
Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Sumana asate. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Sumana asate. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Sumana asate. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Sumana asate. Yatha na sarva mijjagada yakshmagum. Sumana asate.
After I finish, all the four of you start at the same time. Yatha nasarva.
Yatha nasarva. Yatha nasarva.
Mijagada.
Mijagada. Mijagada.
Yakshmagum.
Yakshmagum. Yakshmagum.
Sumana asat.
Sumana asat.
Sumana. You have to. Exactly, it's like a parrot. You have to repeat, you have to listen to every sound. The way I say, you have to exactly. Subhana asat.
Subhana asat.
Subhana
asat.
Yatha nasarva mijagada.
Yatha nasarva mijagada.
Thana sarva mijagada.
Thana
sarva
mijagada.
Thana
sarva mijagada.
Yakshmagum sumana asat.
Yakshmagum sumana asat.
Yakshmagum sumana asat. Please hold on. Anytime I will ask you to, so you have to fully concentrate, because anytime I will ask more of you to say. If you don't listen properly at this, when you are doing, then it will be difficult when I ask you to do it separately. Adhyavocha.
Adhyavocha. Adhyavocha. Adhyavocha.
Great.
Adhyavocha.
Dadhi Bhakta. Dadhi Bhakta.
Dadhi Bhakta. Dadhi Bhakta. Dadhi Bhakta.
First is Da, then second is Di. So the second is the fourth. Fourth Da, the hard Da. First is soft, da, di, da, di. Adhyavocha da, di, bhakta.
Adhyavocha da, di, bhakta. Adhyavocha da, di, bhakta. Adhyavocha da, di, bhakta. Adhyavocha da, di, bhakta.
Adhyavocha da, di, bhakta.
Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta. Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta.
Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta.
Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta.
Prathamo daivyo bhishak.
Prathamo daivyo bhishak. Prathamo daivyo bhishak.
Prathamo daivyo Bhishak
Prathamo Daivyo Bhishak Prathamo Daivyo Bhishak Prathamo Daivyo Bhishak Prathamo Daivyo Bhishak
Adhyavocha Dadhi Bhaktam
Adhyavocha Dadhi Bhaktam Adhyavocha Dadhi Bhaktam Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta. Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta.
Prathamo daivyo bhishak.
Prathamo daivyo bhishak. Prathamo daivyo bhishak. Prathamo daivyo bhishak. Prathamo daivyo bhishak. Prathamo daivyo bhishak. Prathamo daivyo bhishak.
Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta. Prathamo daivyo bhishak.
Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta. Prathamo daivyo bhishak. Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta. Prathamo daivyo bhishak. Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta prathamo daivyo bhishak.
Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta. So that bhakta, you have to slightly elongate that ta, because next is pra. Then only this sound is ipra. So if you have to get that ip sound before the pra, you have to slightly elongate. That is the technique of chanting. Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta. Ta prata ipra adhyavocha dadhi bhakta prathamo daivyo bhishak
adhyavocha dadhi bhakta prathamo daivyo bhishak adhyavocha dadhi bhakta prathamo daivyo bhishak Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta prathamo daivyo bhishak Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta prathamo daivyo bhishak Adhyavocha dadhi bhakta prathamo daivyo bhishak
Ahigascha
Ahigascha Ahigascha
Sarvan Jambayan
Sarvan Jambayan Sarvan Jambayan Sarvan Jambayan Sarvan Jambayan Sarvan Jambayan Sarvan Jambayan
Ahigascha sarvan jambayan
Ahigascha sarvan jambayan. Ahivasya sarva jambayan. Ahivasya sarva jambayan. Ahivasya sarva jambayan.
Sarvaschayatu.
Sarvaschayatu. Sarvaschayatu. Sarvaschayatu.
Dhanyaha.
Dhanyaha. Dhanyaha. Dhanyaha. Dhanyaha.
Sarvaschayatu. Dhanyaha.
Sarvaschayatu. Dhanyaha. Sarvaschayatu. Dhanyaha. Sarvaschayatu. Dhanyaha. Sarvaschayatu. Dhanyaha.
Ahivasya sarvan jambayant.
Ahivasya sarvan jambayant. Ahivasya sarvan jambayant.
Jambayant. Ahivasya sarvan jambayant.
Ahivasya sarvan jambayant. Ahivasya sarvan jambayant. Ahivasya sarvan jambayant.
Sarvaschayatu dhanyaha.
Sarvaschayatu dhanyaha. Sarvaschayatu dhanyaha.
Ahivasya sarvan jambayant. Sarvaschayatu dhanyaha.
Ahivasya sarvan jambayant. Sarvaschayatu dhanyaha. Ahivasya sarvan jambayant. Sarvaschayatu
sarvaschayatu
sarvaschayatu dhanyaha. Ahivasya sarvan jambayant. 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 Sarvaschayatu dhanyaha.
Asau vyastamro aruna.
Asau vyastamro aruna. Asau vyastamro aruna. Asau vyastamro aruna. Asau vyastamro aruna.
Asau
vyastamro aruna.
So small gap after tamro. Asau vyastamro aruna.
Asau vyastamro aruna. Asau vyastamro aruna. Asau vyastamro aruna. Asau vyastamro aruna.
Uta bhavrusu mangalah.
Uta bhavrusu mangalah. Uta bhavrusu mangalah. Uta bhavrusu mangalah. Uta bhavrusu mangalah. Uta bhavrusu mangalah. Uta bhavrusu mangalah.
Asau vyastamro aruna uta bhavrusu mangalah.
Asau vyastamro aruna uta bhavrusu mangalah. Asau vyastamro aruna uta bhavrusu mangalah. Asau vyastamro aruna uta bhavrusu mangalah. Asau vyastamro aruna uta bhavrusu mangalah. Asau yas samro aruna udabhavrusu mangalah. Asau yas samro aruna udabhavrusu mangalah.
Ye che magum.
Ye che magum. Ye che magum.
So here it is ya, ye. It is ya, ye. It is not the vowel a. It is the consonant which in English you can say ye. It's not a. A is the vowel a. Here it is a consonant ya, ye.
Ye che magum. Ye che magum. Ye che magum. Ye che magum.
Rudra.
Rudra. Rudra.
Adhito.
Adhito. Adhito.
Dikshu.
Dikshu. Dikshu. Dikshu.
Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu.
Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu. Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu.
Ye che magum.
Ye che magum. Ye che magum. Ye che magum. Ye che magum.
Rudra.
Rudra. Rudra.
So after Rudra, slight gap you have to do for
Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu.
Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu. Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu. Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu. Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu. Ye che magum. Rudra. Abhito dikshu.
Shrita Sahasra.
Shrita Sahasra. Shrita Sahasra. Shrita Sahasra. Shrita Sahasra.
Shrita Sahasra. Shrita Sahasra. Shrita Sahasra.
Shrita Sahasra. Shrita Sahasra.
Shovai Shagum.
Shovai Shagum. Shovai Shagum. Shovai Shagum. Shovai Shagum.
So also, when this is another Vedic chanting rule, when there are two lower ones, the second low should be still slightly lower than the previous low. So that is again the book, they cannot mark, they will just put lower. Shovai Shagum. So it becomes the next low becomes slightly lower than the previous low. Both. So just this is just these are all some subtle things we have to get.
Shovai Shagum.
Shovai Shagum. Shovai Shagum. Shovai Shagum.
Hedaimahe.
Hedaimahe. Hedaimahe. Hedaimahe. Hedaimahe.
Ye che magum. Rudra.
Ye che magum. Rudra. Ye che magum. Rudra. Ye che magum. Rudra.
That gu, you should not give any stress.
Ye che magum. Rudra.
Ye che magum. Rudra. Ye che magum. Rudra.
Abhito dikshu.
Abhito dikshu. Abhito dikshu. Arito dikshu.
Shrita Sahasra.
Shrita Sahasra. Shruta Sahasra
Shovaishagum
Shovaishagum Shovaishagum
Hedaimahe
Hedaimahe
Ye Chemagum Rudra Abhito Dikshu Shrita Sahasra Shovaishagum Hedaimahe
Ye Chemagum Rudra Abhito Dikshu Shrita Sahasra Shovaishagum Hedaimahe Ye Chemahum Rudra
Ye Chemahum
Ye Chemahum Rudra Adito Deviksho Sveta Sahasra Shobai Chagum Ye Radimahe Ye Chemahum Rudra Adito Deviksho Sveta Sahasra Shobai Chagum Ye Radimahe Ye Chemahe Ye Chemahum Rudra Adito Deviksho Sveta Sahasra Shobai Chagum Ye Radimahe Ye Chemahum Rudra Adito Deviksho Sveta Sahasra Shobai Chagum Ye Radimahe
That Magum Gum is, there is no, it was, it is up, not up, it is just middle. Ye, che, ma, gum. Ma, gum. Then it becomes up. You have to be very careful. Ye, che, ma, gum. Rudra, abhito, dikshu, shreta, sagasra, shovai, shagum, hedaimahe.
Ye Chemagum Rudra Adito Deviksho Shrita Sahasra Shobai Chagum Hedaimahe Ye Chemagum Rudra Adito Deviksho Shrita Sahasra Shobai Chagum Hedaimahe
Okay.
Ye Chemagum Rudra Adito Deviksho Shrita Sahasra Shobai Chagum Hedaimahe
So I will just chant all from the beginning once, then you can just listen.
Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya Om Namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha Namaste Astu Dhanvane Bhagubhya Mutate Namaha Yata Isho Shivatama Shivam Babhuvate Thanuhu Shivasha Ravyaya Tavatayano Rudra Mridaya Yate Rudra Shiva Tanura Ghora Papakashini Tayanas Tanuva Shantama Yagiri Shanta Pichakashi Yame Shungiri Shanta Haste Bibharshyastave Shivam Giretratam Kuru Mahigum Sif Purusham Jagat Shivena Vachasatva Girisha Chavadamasi Yathana Sarvamijagada Yakshmagum Sumana Asat Adhyavocha Dadhi Vakta Prathamo Daivyo Pishak Ahigascha sarvaan jambhayan sarvaascha yatu dhanyaham asauvyas Tamro Aruna Uta Babrusu Mangalaha Ye Chemagum Rudra Abhito Dikshusrita Sagasra Shovaishagum Hedai Mahe.
So I think we finished up to this today. So what I will, I will just show you. So anybody have any questions or? Just,
yeah?
So all this is already recorded. So if you want any
email,
yeah, it is in the you can check on the Bhaskara Prakasha Ashram. Okay. It will be on the YouTube.
Okay.
So it is already recorded. So if anybody have any questions, you just you have any questions, or do you find it difficult or easy, or what is like each one? I know each one it will be different. So what do you think? Was it?
Yeah, it was. It's so tough. Yeah,
tough. But you are able to get,
yeah,
or
I'm able to get it.
Get it. That's good.
A lot of focus, I think.
You need a lot of concentration. So the I think mainly for the four kids, right? These four. I just want to say, you need like a tremendous focus and concentration, because when I was learning, the good thing was, because if you learn the Rudram, for me, when I go to school, it was I used to learn from the morning 4 o'clock the Vedic Adhyayanam, then I go to school. But the good thing was, others were saying, because I am spending another extra 4 or 5 hours extra learning, my other students will think, oh, I am able to cope up with the other things in the school. But the good thing is, if you learn Rudram or other Vedic things, in the school, I just have to learn only once all the other subjects, like whether it's maths or science. If I know once, that is it. I don't have to, I will never come back, and I don't have to, I don't have to revise or anything. I will just go to the exam and I can write. I just sit in the class once, because the good thing is, as he rightly said, this needs so much of focus. It needs, when you train your brain, then the other learnings becomes very easy, because then you will see that they are all, why others are spending so much time learning this science, because it is just, you read once, it is sufficient. Then you will think whether you need to go to school to learn, because you can learn yourself. I'm just saying, this the Vedic learning before, that is why our rishis, they could, you will be wondering how they could by heart, like they can chant for any Gana particle without seeing the book. I don't know whether you have seen, they can chant for at least 3 days continuously. That is all unique one, different ones. They don't need the book at all. You will be wondering how in 3 days, so much of chanting, how they are able to memorize. Our brain, when you focus and you train your brain to do something, our brain gets better and better. And if you don't use the brain, it becomes poorer and poorer. So that's just the brain's function. So did you find it difficult or?
No, I have to unlearn some of the other things. No,
okay.
I've been chanting this for years still. Okay. There are some subtleties.
So the other thing is, unlearning is, as he rightly said, it is a bit difficult. Because once you learn, that particular swaram comes into your mind always. So without our realizing that, so when you learn, the wrong swaram goes to your mind, that is the wrong. That is why when I was learning, my grandfather made sure that if there are other group chanting, he will make sure I never go or listen to that. Because unfortunately, 95% of chanting you are outside, you see, there are, as I said, they follow the 80-20 rule. They are only 80% correct. So unfortunately, even if you do 100%, you can pick up that wrong thing. So we have to focus ourselves to make sure that we don't get that wrong swarams. And you, what is your name? Aditya, your name? Akash.
My name?
Yeah.
Amrit.
No, Anirudh.
Anirudh and you?
Krishna.
Krishna, right? So you have to make sure you have focus. So I see that. I know it is difficult. I think your parents also have to get this. This is you. It will be useful for you, not just here, for your school, anything you do, it will be useful for you. So make sure that, because you want to excel, right, in your school, you want to be the best in school, then you have to be best here also. That is the most important thing.
Yes, Swaram going up and down, is there any meaning to it? Is there any reason for it? Or is it only for the hearing?
No. So, the Swarams have, when I started the class with the Taittiriya Upanishad, where it says the six things, right? Which is Iksham, Vyakhya, Varnaha, which is the letter, Swaraha. You have to be like, anytime I ask you, you should know the six things for the basic rules for chanting, which is first is Varnaha, the letter. Swaraha is the up and down and middle. Swara, Varna, Swaraha, Matra, which is the length of each letter. Balam is the strength you give, for each, how you pronounce. Matra, Balam, Sama is the speed, and also at the chanting in a very nice, good voice. It has to be like when somebody listens to you are chanting, they should immediately come and sit and say, okay, let me first hear this. It should be that attractive. So it should be very smooth. All these are the requisites. And in the Veda part itself, there are different reasons why the meaning changes, not just by what the letter. Right. For example, name of a girl's name Arthi, right? So Arthi means wealth. So you call a girl like Arthi means you call wealth. But the same Arthi, when you use this soft letter Ta, Arthi, then it is exactly opposite meaning. Arthi means Sarvasyarthi Hare Devi Narayani Namostute. There, when you say in Durga Saptashti, Sarvasyarthi Hare Devi, you all remember from Saptashti, Sarvasyarthi Hare Devi means Sarvasyarthi. In this case, means the bad things. So, from remove, then Hare means kill or remove, kill all the bad things. So, Arthi is a very good thing, which is wealth, and Arthi is wealth, and Arthi is not a good thing. So, subtle Varnaha, the letter, when you chant with a small difference also, the meaning changes. Same thing the Swaram. There is actually in the Vedic portion itself, there is a saying that I forgot that Rishi, there is a story. I think when I gave the Taittiriya Upanishad, I have given the Taittiriya Upanishad 1 hour. It is in the Bhaskara Prakasha Ashram website. It is in English, the meaning for Taittiriya Upanishad, where I elaborated on why Swaram is required. There, this Vritra, he was praying, doing a sacrifice to say that his son should kill Indra. So he made a small error in the Swaram, which changed completely the meaning, that he became, what happened, the Indra killed his son, because that small change, so everything was perfect, except that Swaram, small change was in the Swaram. So our Rishis have said that the Swarams are so important that previously, if you would have seen the Vedic chanting, they wanted to make sure that only those who are really focused and they want to really learn it correctly were allowed to learn. The reason is that all these are not, you cannot just say, okay, I just want to, because that somebody else is also chanting, somebody is learning, I also want to learn, it doesn't work here. So because the meaning, as to answer your question, meaning does change when the swara changes. And that is a very important thing. And the swaras have other corollary benefits. One is, when I said that our rishis and our sages, they are able to remember for so many years or so many pages, tons and tons of text of Vedic text. The only reason is it has a swaram. Initially, you may think that the initial learning it is much harder because of the swaram. But later on, you will realize that the swaram is the one which is helping you to remember the actual text. Because the swaram, even if you forget, sometimes when you don't get the swaram, you will not even get the next letter. Next word will not come. So the swaram becomes that important later on also. That is also another benefit that you will be able to remember without seeing the book only because it has swaram. Third thing is, when there are thousands of, I explained this also, start, when thousands are actually chanting, when all learn at the same swaram, and there will be one unique, one voice. So when I said that the Upanishad also said that it should be very pleasing to the ears. When people chant in a different way, some are saying, Om Namo, some say Namo, each one is giving different sounds, it will not sync also. So so there are so many other. One is the main reason is that the meaning changes. The other reasons are that we are able to remember fully, and and also it looks very pleasing when everybody chants together. So that those are the reasons. Any other questions? Or anyway, do you want me to go fast, go slow? What do you think?
No, I just reading. Hmm? I think we should go in the same speed.
Good.
It gives an opportunity just to.
Okay.
Practice again, like four times.
Yeah, so once, because it is recorded, it is in the Bhaskara Prakasha Ashram, Rudram and Chamakam, that is the name of the class. So I would encourage all of you, particularly the parents, should make sure the kids are also getting it, that they are able to practice it and then get it correctly. So that's the main thing.
Can you do Chamakam two lines at least?
You want to write? Oh, okay. Just okay. Minutes. So, yeah. So, we will just do the So, Chamakam, we'll just start the Chamakam today.
Yeah. Yeah.
Om, Om Agna Vishnu.
Om Agna Vishnu. Om Agna Vishnu. Om Agna Vishnu. Om Agna Vishnu.
Sajosha Sema Vardhanto.
Sajosha Sema Vardhanto. Sajosha Sema Vardhanto. Sajosha Sema Vardhanto.
Sajosha
Sajosha Sema Vardhanto. Sajosha Sema Vardhanto.
Sajosha Sema
Sajosha Sema
Sema Sajosha Sema
Sajosha Sema
Vardhanto
Vardhanto Vardhanto Vardhanto Vardhanto
Vam Giraha
Vam Giraha Vam Giraha Vam Giraha
Yumnair Vaje
Yumnair Vaje Yumnair Vaje
Viragatam
Viragatam Viragatam
Yumnair Vaje Viragatam
Yumnair Vaje Viragatam Yumnair Vaje Viragatam Yumnair Vaje Viragatam
Harihi Om
Harihi Om.
So when we start the class, this is again the tradition is you will do a namaskaram at the beginning. You will say Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, and at the end you will also do Arihi Om and then do a namaskaram.
Don't be a lot of limits.
தெரியும்
மன்னவர்
எது